In this video, we are going to walk through how to remove, clean, and reassemble the drain valve in your Decent Espresso machine. And here are tools we need. First, we need to remove the power cord from the machine. For XL or XXL models, first remove the back panel and turn the machine's back switch off, and then unplug the power cord. For Pro and Plus models, turn the machine's back switch off, unplug the power cord. For version 1.43 or higher version machines, which has the slide type tablet stand, unplug the USB cable, pull the tablet stand out gently. And for version 1.3 to version 1.42 machines, which have the screw type tablet stand, unscrew the three screws holding the tablet stand, and then remove the stand. You need to remove the drip tray and drip tray cover, and lift the lever on the back of the machine, and drag the water tank out and remove it, and remove the porter filter and group head handle as well. And now you need to remove the main cover. Use a T10 Torx screwdriver to remove the 8 screws on the main cover. Once all screws are out, gently stretch the sides of the cover and then lift it up off the machine. We need to remove the chassis that the manifold is mounted. If there are Torx T10 size screws, you need to use a Torx T10 screwdriver. Or if you have Phillips head screws, you need to use PH2 size Phillips head screwdriver. Remove the 6 screws screwing the chassis. Start by removing the 2 screws that hold the drain valve mount. You can use either a PH2 or T10 screwdriver by the screw type. Next, remove the clip from the purple tube connector and pull out the tube. Use your fingers or angled pointy tip tweezers. Remove the clip on the black tube connector using angled pointy tip tweezers and pull out the tube. Put on comfort grip gloves to protect your hand from the sharp chassis edges, then unplug the return tube. Use a 5.5mm hex nut driver to remove the 2 nuts securing the ground cables. Make sure to keep the washers. They may stay on the cables or come off with the nuts. Move the ground cables out of the way. And disconnect the drain valve power cable. Press and hold the clip while gently pulling the connector to avoid damaging the socket. If you are using a version 1.43 or earlier, remove the front panel screw first using a T10 Torx screwdriver. Lift the assembly of the ground cable bolts and barb connector holes. If you are only replacing the valve, you can skip disassembling the valve itself and jump to 7 minutes and 57 seconds. Remove the clip connecting the drain valve to the drain box using angled tweezers or long nose pliers, and pull the valve out. Then remove the 5 screws that secure the valve to the mount using a T10 Torx or PH2 screwdriver by the screw type, and detach it from the mount. Now we will separate the valve body from the coil and housing. You will need 2 adjustable wrenches, or a 14mm and a 16mm wrench. Adjustable wrenches are easier to grip. Hold the brass connector with the 16mm wrench and use the 14mm wrench to loosen the bottom nut by turning it counterclockwise. Use your fingers to remove the nut. There is a thicker washer between the coil housing and the nut. Pull the valve body out of the coil housing. There is a thinner washer at the top of the housing. Hold the brass connector with the 16mm wrench and use the 14mm wrench to unscrew the nut below it. As before, loosen it until you can unscrew the connector by hand. Remove the brass connector from the valve body. Take out the plunger and spring and inspect the rubber tip at the bottom. If the rubber is missing or damaged, the valve won't function correctly. If it's dirty or has scale buildup, you just need to clean it. Bring the valve body to the sink and rinse it under running water. Reinsert the plunger into the valve body and make sure the spring compresses and rebounds smoothly. Reattach the brass connector to the valve body and tighten it securely using the wrenches. Insert the valve body through the thinner washer and reinstall it into the coil housing. Place the thicker washer at the bottom of the coil housing and secure it with the nut, tightening it firmly with the wrenches. Reattach the valve to the mount using the 5 screws. Use straight pointed tip tweezers to help position the screw behind the overpressure valve. Tighten the first 4 screws halfway to allow for alignment, then tighten all 5 fully once everything is in place. Now reconnect the drain valve to the drain box. There is an O-ring in the connector. Use a T10 Torx screwdriver to remove the O-ring. Insert the tip of the screwdriver behind the O-ring wall. Gently pry it out. And place it onto the end of the valve. Then insert the valve back into the connector. If it feels tight, use a gentle circular motion as you push it in. Once fully inserted, the narrower section of the valve will be visible through the clip slot. Then reinsert the clip. Reinstall the drain valve assembly into the machine. If you are replacing the valve, this is the point where you can resume the video after removal. Make sure to route the group head ground cable behind the assembly before fully setting it. Reconnect the return tube. You may want to wear gloves to protect your hand from chassis edges. Position the ground cable ends onto the bolts. Group head ground cable goes on to the right, and heater ground cables on the left. Ensure the washers are placed on top. Reattach the nuts onto the bolts. Start by hand tightening them with your fingers. Then use a 5.5mm nut driver to securely fasten them. Plug the drain valve power cable into the drain valve board. Push the connector in firmly until it clicks or is fully seated. Reinsert the black drain tube. The O-ring should still be in the connector. Don't remove it. Push the tube in gently using a circular motion. It might be a little stiff, but don't use excessive force to avoid damaging the O-ring. Once the tube is fully inserted, the brass tip will no longer be visible through the clip connector. Then reinsert the clip. Repeat the same process for the purple tube. Reinstall the 2 screws securing the drain valve assembly. tighten the first screw halfway to allow alignment for the second. Tighten the second screw fully, then go back and fully tighten the first screw. If your machine is version 1.43 or earlier and had a front panel screw, reinstalling it using the T10 Torx screwdriver. There you have it. If you have any questions or run into any difficulties during the replacement process, feel free to reach out.